It is reported that Ali radiallahu anhu has said, زوج ابنتك تقيا إن أحبها أكرمها وإن أبغضها لم يظلمها. Get your daughters married to those who are fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If they love them, they will honor them. And if they dislike them, at least they won't oppress them. They'll send them home in one piece. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding that when a divorce occurs, don't become too bitter about it. It has happened. It's not the first divorce, nor is it the last divorce. Don't become too bitter. Understand, if that girl has come back home in one piece without being oppressed, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that our daughter is back home. It might not be the ideal situation, but at least she was not beaten till her bones broke. And remember, wife bashing is haram. Here in these verses, the issue of the beating is mentioned in these verses, but the understanding is not my understanding, nor is it yours. The understanding of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. That does not mean, right, the Quran has told me I'm allowed to bash a woman, bring my baseball bat, let me bat her. No, that is absolutely haram. Do you know that a marriage can be nullified by the group of ulama if a husband has bashed his wife? If that was permissible, why then would it be allowed to nullify the marriage just through him having beaten her? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So those people who are going around saying the Quran allows a man to beat a woman, they don't know what they're talking about. The Quran says that when, as a last resort, a woman is not listening and she does not want to look at you when you are talking to her, you may draw her attention by tapping her. That is the term. Darb does not necessarily mean to go out and beat and thump and thud. If that was the case, we would have read so many ahadith of the Sahaba having done that, radiallahu anhum. They didn't do that. But when we read the ahadith, they used a siwak. Do you know what is a siwak? A small stick which is used to clean the teeth, compared to the baseball bats that we are using today. A small stick that is used to clean the teeth, that was only used to draw the attention of the women. That was how they understood wadribuhunna. That is how they understood it. So why should we then try and say, no, the Quran doesn't have that verse, when we go and speak to those modernists and those people who want to now delete verses of the Quran? Don't deny it. Say, look, the understanding is the understanding of the Sahaba. And also over and above that, a woman who's been bashed, you have the right to apply to the ulama, to the bodies, to the ulama authorities in the Muslim countries, to the courts, and that marriage will be nullified on those grounds. If it was permissible, how could it have been nullified? So let's understand the Sharia. There's no loopholes in Islam. And there is nothing barbaric in this Sharia. That is the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.